My name is Pastor Chekerwa. Jesus is coming again. The greatest announcement of the century. The greatest announcement of the year. In Acts chapter 5, verse 29. Then Peter and the other disciples answered and said, "We ought to obey God rather than men." They were in trouble, in a crisis. May I prepare you? Before Christ comes, there's going to be a crisis where you have to make a choice whether you obey God or you obey the traditions of men, whether you obey God or the culture, whether you obey God or the laws of men. Peter and the other apostles, there are a lot of people today who call themselves apostles, and yet they don't want to do things according to what God says. Then the Bible says, Peter and his friends, the apostles, they said, we ought to. There is no way we can obey men when there's a voice of God. There are two voices that are in the world, even as we go towards the end. Christ is about to come, and these voices are getting louder and louder. Voice of the world and the voice of God. Voice of evil and the voice of good. The voice of the evil one and the voice of the good one. Unrighteous voice and righteous voice. All these voices are here. There's a great controversy in your home, in your mind, everywhere. This great controversy is where you have to choose whether you obey God or you obey men. This crisis is real. It's coming. It's here. Don't you feel it? That this morning when you woke up, there was this controversy. Should I do right or I do wrong? And then Peter says, together with the other apostles, we would rather obey God rather than men. Those that are called by the name of the Lord stand on one side. You would rather obey God all the way. Don't allow anything to come between you and your God. Is it Paul who said, what can separate us from the love of God? Meaning, the love of God reaches down to where we are so that we can be able to decide for Him. There are challenges in the world. Today, it's like the devil is marketing his products in such a way that if you are not careful, it's easy to fall for him. But those that are called by his name, they shouted, would rather die, would rather obey the law of God, would rather do all that we can rather than obey the voice of men. The voices of men are getting louder. There are lights blinking everywhere from the evil one. But I want you to understand, in times like these, obey the voice of God. It may not be very loud. It can come as a still small voice. It can come as a whisper. But only God, and God only, is the one who can save you out of this crisis. The crisis that we are going through, it's only God. The pandemics, it's only God. Everything that we are going through, it's only the voice of God and God alone. Like Peter of old and his apostles, let's answer back to the world and say, we ought to obey God rather than men. He is coming soon to collect those that obey him and not those that run with what is happening around them. Yes, Jesus is coming to pick those that obey his word. May God bless you.